So imagine you're sitting on your couch one day and you're being a bum and you just want to turn off the lights or switch a channel, but you don't want to get up. Imagine being able to write up an entire email by just thinking about it, or even creating an entire film or character or story by just focusing hard enough and then suddenly realizing that you've created this character on screen. So today we're going to discuss that future and how NextMind's new technology is going to get us there. Hi, I'm Omz, and welcome to OmzLaw. If you're new to the channel and you're enjoying this content, please like and subscribe, as that will really help me grow this channel and get it where it needs to be. When I was a kid, I was hoping that sometime in the future we'd be able to make our own films by just thinking about them or by dreaming about them. I saw it on a film once called Final Fantasy: The Spirits Within, whereby the main character called Aki uses this computer to record her dreams, and basically she saves them onto a folder. And I thought, you know, how much easier would it be to shoot a film this way? Instead of spending time hiring crew, trying to communicate your vision through storyboarding or through shot lists or by speaking to your DP or your designers, how much easier would it be to just imagine the shot and for it to exist? How much cooler would it be to do this on your own, to have your vision exactly matched to what you originally intended it to be? Just imagine, instead of having to cast an actor, you would just imagine the character exactly the way you want them to be. Well, this is not the same thing, but it's definitely a step in the right direction. So NextMind's technology is a compact comb-shaped sensor, which is extremely comfortable and private and is basically the best measurement of neural activity in the market. Well, that's according to them at least. The control of the digital environment is surprisingly simple. According to Sid, who is a professor in cognitive neuroscience and the founder and CEO of NextMind, the technology breakthrough represents the next frontier of human-computer interaction. Sid's lab specializes in decoding consciousness directly from neural activity, which is non-invasive, unlike Elon Musk's Neuralink, which does require some surgery, even though it's pretty easy. NextMind's technology relies on neural imaging methods that are used in babies, sleepers, or coma patients. After several discoveries, he was obsessed with creating NextMind, and I've left a link to his talk whereby he elaborates on his ideas. The concept here is to make this real time, to increase the bandwidth without undergoing surgery. Therefore, NextMind had to innovate on several fronts. They had to create a new innovative design with better sensors and new materials, and they also had to combine it with new machine learning algorithms that interprets data in real time, without sending any signal in return. So how does it work? Well, according to their website, NextMind's technology works on direct brain commands and decodes the act of focusing. So it starts off by tagging the object with faint graphic overlays specially optimized for the visual cortex. Everything you see in the real world is essentially illustrated or visualized inside of your visual cortex. For example, when you are facing an object, your eyes project an image of that object to the visual cortex. So when you focus your attention on an object, the image itself would be highlighted or enlarged in the visual cortex. NextMind's sensor picks up the electrical brainwaves that are generated by the visual cortex and decodes them using machine learning, thereby pinpointing the object. From the moment the user starts focusing, they can see their brain acting on the object. And as they focus more, the neural feedback on the digital object increases until it obeys their command. So I bet some of you are asking right now, you know, is it safe? And yes, according to them, their product has been certified by regulatory authorities in all countries that they ship to. NextMind's technology uses electroencephalography, and trust me, that was hard to pronounce, especially after visiting the dentist. Electroencephalography is an electrophysiological monitoring method used to record electrical activity of the brain. So in layman's terms, most of these techniques are non-invasive and are basically electrodes that are placed along the scalp. This technique has been used for almost a century to measure neural signals at the surface of the head. So what does this new technology bring to neurotech? For developers, this is great as this is accessible, easy to use, adaptable, and almost unlimited. The developers don't need to worry about the processing of the neural signals. That's all done by NextMind. All they have to worry about is creating new environments and experiences. I would like to wrap up here by stating the benefits of something like this, especially for people who face physical disability issues that prevents them from moving around or controlling other devices. What's also so fascinating here is that the product is available today to order on their site, and it's only $400. This isn't a product placement, I'm just highlighting how expensive or cheap it is in relation to the other gaming consoles or VR sets. And basically for that, you're getting a sensor that has an adjustable headband, the algorithms that transform the neural signals into command, and tutorials, demo apps, and examples. And that's all I have for today. Let me know what you guys think and how NextMind's technology can change filmmaking in the future. Don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms. And as always, thank you for watching.